Great. So hi, everybody. My name is Kelly Burrows. I work for IBWave Solutions, a network design software. And I'm really here to ask the question around building modeling, its role in the network design lifecycle, and if there might be a better way at some point in the future down the road to approach it. So to do that, let's start by looking at what the current state of what that is, right? So you get a project, one of the first things you need to do is typically find the floor plan somehow. Sometimes that's easy to do, sometimes that's harder to do. Typically it might come in a CAD file if you're lucky, or maybe a PDF or an image file, right? Or we have customers who are taking pictures of the emergency exit plans on the, in the buildings using the mobile app. At some point you take that and then you put it into your network design software of choice and you model the building, right? That could take hours depending on the complexity and the level of detail you want to get to. Or in some cases, if you know IBWave, you've seen some of the 3D modeling that our customers do, especially for complex venues like a stadium. They get really, really detailed, and that can take, you know, a couple of weeks, which is probably not ideal. And I think the question we're asking is, you know, is modeling a venue in a network design software, is that really a value-add task for an RF engineer to do, or is there a better way to do it in the future? Right. So another question or consideration on this topic is the shifting definition of what a good user experience is going to be. So we're shifting from, like, today in the older days of, you know, do I have connectivity? So we're all here with our tablets and cell phones, and we're happy if we can upload a selfie or a video and share it. And, you know, it's great if we have that connectivity. And that's shifting more towards what is connectivity going to give me, right? So when you start thinking about the buildings that are being constructed and all of the IoT, they're becoming smart buildings in a smart city, you know, with this whole vision of a smart world somehow, right? So that end user experience is shifting towards more, hey, I just walked into a room. Why isn't the heating adjusting? Why aren't the lights the way I like it? And like, where's that wireless robot dog with my espresso the way I need it, right? So all of this user experience is really shifting more towards that. And then, when you look at a smart building and what it takes to actually make that happen, well, it's a lot more complicated than building or constructing a building today, right? So you have all of these different devices that now need to enable that user experience. So you have the smart windows person, you have the heating person, the lighting person, the electrical, HVAC, all of these different parties and all of these devices, and they're just pieces of the puzzle that you need to put together to create kind of these smart buildings and these smart settings, right? So how can we work more collaboratively so that we can enable that end user experience in the future? The good news is the construction industry is actually tackling this problem now, right? It's always been an issue in the construction industry around collaboration because there's so many different parties involved when it comes to putting a building together. So, and they're doing that by standardizing a BIM file. So when you look at a BIM file, there's essentially seven standard layers within a BIM file, all kind of defined and added to by all the different parties. So you have the architectural, which is like your walls and roof, your surfaces, the structural services, the finishes. All of this is going into the BIM model, but it's a single source of truth that's now being collaborated on by the architects, the engineers, all of those different contractors, and all of the building owners. So it's really driving collaboration in the construction industry. And so the question we kind of have at IBWave is, when you think about wireless today and connectivity today, you know, it's really considered the fifth utility in a building, or it probably should be at this point, right? So why is wireless kind of still on the outside of this BIM model, and why aren't we being more collaborative with that industry in general? So we're thinking that connectivity and wireless should become the next standard layer in a BIM model, and that we can be part of a larger collaborative effort to enable these buildings, which is going to enable the, you know, the new user experience in the future. So at IBWave, we've been working on how can we kind of help make that happen for our customers. And the first step is, allowing the import of a BIM file. So this is something that's in development, probably going to be out in beta. We're exploring the value of it. Does it make sense? Will it be used? But to give you a look of what it's going to look like. So here's like a, I don't know, a typical building you might find on a campus environment, right? So this maybe would take a couple days to model by hand, but here we've just taken the BIM model that's already been built and actually been modeled in a proper modeling software like Revit, let's say, and we're just importing that, and that literally just now takes minutes to do. So now I've got all the layers of the building, and I have all of the information contained in that building, right? So here you can see it's opening up in our 3D viewer. And it's really going to give you three things when you can do this. It's, first of all, time saver. If you think this is a simple building, but expand this out to a stadium, which can take weeks, right? Well, now you've got a stadium imported in, like, minutes. Second of all, you've got a really accurate model because you've taken all the information from the actual building plans, that BIM file, so now you're going to get a really accurate model to get your accurate prediction when you run a layer in your wireless. And three, you're now part of a larger collaboration with everyone else, so you're going to give them visibility, into the wireless, and you're going to have visibility into what everyone else is doing. So the dream is, kind of once you have it in, you start layering in your wireless, right? And this essentially becomes a live digital asset, and so maybe you're adding in your Wi-Fi network, but in these buildings, you're probably going to have Wi-Fi for some things. You're going to use private LTE for your more critical applications. You're going to have IoT in there, but essentially you can start layering in your wireless. And then the dream becomes take that, export it out, and so all those other parties now have visibility into what you've done for wireless. And now I'm going to take it one step further. What we're seeing is when it comes to private LTE right now, there's a lot of like campus environments deploying private LTE. So think educational, mining, logistics. All of them have kind of a larger campus environment, indoor and outdoor. And they don't want just like a standalone view of one single building that was designed in a software. They want a more holistic view. And so we have an API which allows you now to take your building design and then export that out onto a GIS map, right? And so this is going to enable that holistic view. So when you export it, again, it's a live digital asset. You're exporting it out onto your GIS map, and you have all of the equipment, all of your cabling, all of your prediction in there. And it's going to now enable the IT administrators to have a portal. So we're seeing a lot of our larger like SIs building out portals for their private networks to allow IT administrators of these campus-like environments to now have this type of a view of their network. So now you're not just monitoring a single building somewhere, you're monitoring your whole network. And when you change something somewhere, you can see the impact everywhere else because it's a live document of sorts. So I don't know, at this point, it's more of a question, a vision, topic for conversation. If it happens or not, who knows? But it's food for thought. And in case nobody found that interesting, I'll leave you with my latest wireless joke, and hopefully it can make a couple of you guys laugh. That's it. Thanks so much.